Go on, have a chat with yourself. What sort of thing are, mate? It's a bit of alcohol. So if we don't burn, we drink it. He's great, man. He loves it. He's doing the brandies and everything like that's going out of fashion. We did some people in the pub there a few minutes ago.
He invited us back to watch the match. Barcelona versus Madrid, which is a massive match.
Yeah, you happy with that?
I even brought a wooden spoon.
Yeah, I just
do you want to fling that into it? Here's my tent. Check that out. I've got luxury tonight.
What, darling?
Yeah.
Oh.
That's the way it happens.
I wouldn't say Rudy's was luxury, more like.
Bloody hailstones this morning.
Brian just after saying to me, I was trying him there on the phone. We didn't get them at all.
Have I washed my hands?
Yeah.
That evening, we went into Esgrau to the bar and met an English couple who really kindly invited us back to their house to watch the football that evening. Their house was in the middle of nowhere in the darkness in a wood. And what we didn't expect was for them to give us their car.
So we're actually driving along a tiny little track in some
random people's houses. And they've just given us a car!
We met them in a pub.
We met them in a pub at 4:30. Got invited back at 4:55. And then they gave us a car.
He's just watched me drink 5 beers in his house.
And then here's the keys to my car. Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. You couldn't wish for any better.
You couldn't write this.
I'm checking it back, the brakes.
Your front right wheel is quite low. And like air.
Unbelievable, isn't he? He's unbelievable.
He just gives you a car.
Lovely man.
And she was trying to get him to come and pick us back up.
Yeah.
So I think enough is enough. Oh, brilliant, man.
Fantastic.
We're going to crank the fire up?
Nah, sure, why not?
What time we got?
11, I have to tell.
Okay, about 6-7 kilometres into day 3. Today we're walking from Esgrau to Cala Tirant, and today is a 33 kilometre stretch, which I'll find out what that is in miles at some point, but I would have said it's got to be like a marathon. It's got to be 26 miles, I don't know, we'll find out, but it's going to be a long distance today. Slept okay in the tent last night, although there was frost on our camping stove this morning, so it's chilly. But at the moment, I don't want to speak too soon, but the whole knee situation's working out okay. I feel pretty good. Look, I know I look blooming out of breath. I feel fine. And I'm loving the scenery. I'm loving everybody who's here with me. We've got a beautiful gang of people. So that helps a big amount. So I'll show you some of the beautiful sights I see as I go along and see how we get on through the day. But this is going to be the longest distance we do at any point on the hike today. But we've got an extremely fun night waiting us. Entertainment's going to be set, laid on for us, and a party and a fire. So I'm looking forward to tonight. It'll be a big reward at the end of it. See you later.
Thank you.
'cause I would walk 500 miles, and I would walk 500 more just to be the man who walks 1,000 miles to end up at your door. Da 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 da.
Morning. Day 4, first thing in the morning. Last night we had a brilliant night with a campfire, and we had Richard and Leslie who came over, and Richard sang the guitar, sang lots of songs with his guitar. Lovely evening. And I retired about 10 o'clock, had an early night. The night it absolutely hoonered down with rain, so we're all soaked. So today is the devil's armpit day, which means we've got the hardest walk. There's 2 days of very nasty terrain now, and this is the worst one, and it's not looking good weather wise. We're all absolutely soaked, and you've got to see what Keith and Rudy are sleeping in. It's basically a fisherman's shelter, but they're both in there. They haven't stirred yet. Look at what they're in, how little it is. I think they're very cosy in there. If the rain holds off, then I'll show you what we're facing today, but all prepared with wet weather gear. And let's see if we can enjoy this today. So I went to wake Keith and Rudy up because it's getting close to when everyone's coming to meet us. Peered in their tent, and this is what I saw. No Keith and Rudy, just puddles and all their stuff. Where have they gone? Their poles are still here, their gear is still here, but they're not here. Where can they be? In there? Don't look like it. Oh no.
I can still taste you on my lips, your tenderness. You always gave me something. The way you made me feel before you hit. You're changing me. Not just for us, it's really. That's not what I.